I'm here in Fiji with a team from Australia, what's called a Catholic Schools Youth Ministry Australia team, and it's wonderful to be over here. And we are working with Fijian leaders in conducting a South Pacific equipping school, which is focused on evangelisation of leaders, including teachers, youth ministry leaders, and also leaders in the parish context. And it's wonderful to be here. Our school is very much focused on renewal in faith, understanding that our ministry of leadership needs to be a ministry on evangelisation, and also understanding about the importance of working with young people, and especially youth, the youth ministry program, both in Catholic schools and also in parishes.
First of all, I want to welcome you all again and thank you for responding to the invitation to be at this seminar. I have a lot of hopes for this seminar, and to also thank Peter Woods and the team from Australia for making this initiative and also bringing their experience in Australia to Fiji. This workshop is leadership formation is very important to our Catholic schools. As you know, the challenges that has been going on since the beginning of this year with the open merit recruiting system that does not guarantee us having a Catholic principal. Lately, there has been another movement, and that is the removal of all the chaplains from the government school and the Methodist schools. So there's definitely a strong push for secularism and the secular state concept that's going here in Fiji. And we have to be creative. That's the name of the game, to be creative and to think of ways of promoting and keeping the Catholic character of our school. And I'm sure and I'm confident that this workshop, this program, you want to call it a workshop because the workshop is, you know, it's a one, sometimes a one-off thing. But this program, which begins, but it's an ongoing process, will definitely be a big help to the Catholic schools and the youth ministry.
If you're a leader in a school, you'll become a stronger evangelist. If you're a leader in your parish or ministry, you'll become a stronger evangelist. If you're a young person here, that you will become a stronger evangelist as well. So to make evangelisation your main paradigm.
Oh, turarauna na neureda na bimbi ni di vetumberi tomanda virna luvianda nonra mbula dak chume ni kuan na na kenan rendre sena libuna veka e la kudurumi tu nambul ni ko e rendre vira se mulmulum na nonra turma tu toka se nonra mbula taka na vambo tendina va katolik
building Catholic character. Teachers need to be creative as Catholic culture slowly fades. It's a very important message, is culture, Catholic culture slowly fades.
Kanu believe na ambalatsi na new evangelism. Lebesar na itu tu bar tu mana main na do zak silibui. Membalatsi kan na nungurai na perto Australia satu sarilu. Membalatsi kan na itu tu mana kan youth. Gua me dona puli lebiau. Pati nuna lista lengo na beka lalai kede mimbale tana karna bule talanga na gasni bule au na bule talanga ke mi una mai ba torta kata kata na ni to youth.
I've been given some books yesterday, the curriculum from the youth ministry from Australia, and I'm planning to implement some of the activities in it and bring it to our Fijian context, especially in the primary school level.
Eu nungu ngol tu mai vaka ul ngol mai lala tu mai eu vaka kila ni sati ko na bulin makau ni lot e ndona ka mai vakila vaka me vavuli di talvia un ele unaka ndina ni tuna lotu ya eu mara uni mai vuli di sarang ele unaka nona le hospital mo ra uni buke na ve tumberi na ve rna ngone lo mani korni buli
I've seen a great pleasure in meeting with new friends, because I'm usually a person that keeps to myself. And being able to open up is something new for me, which is I'm grateful for the last 4 days.
What I've learned so far during the South Pacific Equipping School is the importance of your encounter with Jesus Christ. So what I'm planning to do is when I go back to Tonga, I'm going to share my knowledge and experience and use the skills that I've learned so far with the rest of the Catholic youth ministry in Tonga.
Reflecting also on the past 4 days, there, being aware of the current situation here in the Ministry of Education, and even this year I was new to the field of education, and let alone my very first post, I was posted to a non-Catholic schools. Hindu-owned school, which is I was challenging at first, but I thank the Catholic Education Office that they Master Nemani Nrova. After so many emails and letters to the ministry, I was able to get a post in the Catholic schools. And there are many things happening around us in terms of from the Ministry of Education. And not only that, in the process of removing all the chaplain from all other denomination, especially the Methodist, which is very discouraging at times.